See ya.
And we find ourselves at one of the most iconic venues in world football, the Santiago Bernabeu, here in the Spanish capital, Madrid. My name is Derek Ray, joined for commentary tonight by Lee Dixon. And we've got Champions League group stage action to look forward to. It's Real Madrid up against Sporting.
Well, the players love these games, Derek. It's a break from league football, just gives you a little bit of a rest. But you have to focus on different types of players, players you're not used to playing against every week. Do your research, who you're marking, who you're playing against.
Winners of this great competition, Real Madrid. And you always feel, Lee, that no matter the stage of the competition, where Real Madrid are concerned, you're witnessing history.
Well, absolutely. Their history would suggest that they need to win every game because the pressure is always on them, and quite rightly so. And very, very close to my heart because they came over in 99 and played in my testimonial. So I love Real Madrid.
Very generous of them. They chose well. And here's the starting 11 for Real Madrid. If you like wingers, you'll love this, Lee.
Yeah, absolutely. I love to watch a winger play, especially with pace and power. The central striker will stay more or less in front of the goal. The support will be provided by the three central midfield players. The back four is pretty conventional, but the fullbacks will be asked to support from behind.
Now the delivery, and you need your defender to take charge. Hunter! Simple save, really. Well, you never quite know who's going to emerge from the shadows and become a match winner, but this man might be. And a chance for them to nudge in front. That will give them quite the lift. An early opening goal lead.
Well, you always want to start quickly, and there's certainly a quick start there. What a finish. Well, it's not a brilliant goal, but it's a goal. It's in the back of the net. Keeper couldn't do anything about it.
Well, the goal again, albeit from a different angle. And the match back in business, Real Madrid with the advantage. In possession, Wendel. Given away. Beautifully timed. Rafinha. Quick thinking to dispossess his opponent. In possession, Wendel. Here's Battaglia. Wendel. They're succeeding in finding forward gears, but will they produce from this position? Let's see. They don't normally need a second invitation to give it a go on the counter. Looks as though they might make real progress on the counter-attack. Not so. And given away. Alex Hunter gives it a go! So, a Real Madrid corner. And they've gone for the short corner. And he did well to get around to the ball.
Yeah, I'll give him 6 out of 10 for that save. Nothing more, nothing less.
Kroos with the corner. No-nonsense clearance. Throw-ins given. This is Gareth Bale. Hunter. It's there for him. And the goal it is for Real Madrid. They are on a victory course.
Well, here's the replay. I'm sure the keeper will be looking at his defenders, but what can they do? It's a lovely strike off his laces in the back of the net.
A chance to revisit the goal. It's going their way, 2-0. In possession, Wendell. Well, they were clearly on the receiving end, so a free kick is next. Bruno Fernandes. Battaglia. Do they mean business on this occasion? Well, they've jumped in front, Lee. That's the most important thing. Your assessment so far?
Well, it's...
And in with the... Bales through ball. Joy for the Merengues. Real Madrid have scored.
Well, they pushed and pushed. They tested and tested and they got their reward. Well, you tell youngsters in that position just to hit the target. You can't score unless you do. And on this occasion, he does, and he scores.
And the goal that was scored, well worth another look, Lee. Well, it has been one-sided, but they deserve the plaudits for the fact that they've kept going and going. Bruno Fernandes. Here's Battaglia. And a strong tackle. Isco. Here's Carvajal. This is Gareth Bale. On the ball is Mathieu. In possession, Wendell. Battaglia. Bruno Fernandes has it. Here's Rafinha. Wendell. Teamwork might be the key. Effective challenge. Hunter. Real Madrid moving the ball with... Oh, he's through here! Only the keeper to beat! The referee's verdict is 3 additional minutes. Opportunity! Hunter! It's still alive! And that is that. Half-time here in the Spanish capital. I think most fans would be pretty happy with this man's display so far.
Well, the saying in the theatre, take a bow, that's exactly what he should be doing after that first half performance. Just giving the man of the match award now.
And so the second half is underway. They took quite the thrashing in that first 45. Can they turn things around now? Here, superb pass by Marco Asensio. And Hunter, what's he going to do? He's in with a chance. Corner for Real Madrid. And firing it into the area. It lacked conviction, that clearance. And maybe an opportunity for the opposition. And no-nonsense defensive clearance. And given away. Gareth Bale. Tremendous block. He's feeling the pressure here. Now, counter-attacking possibilities here. They've given it away. No real conviction in the challenge. And a goal!
Well, it's not a brilliant goal, but it's a goal. It's in the back of the net. Keeper couldn't do anything about it.
Well, let's take another look at that goal, shall we? Well, they have elected to go to the bench at this stage of the game. There has been a gulf in quality tonight, but you've really got to give them credit for the fact that they haven't let up at all. And 30 minutes left for play in this match. Well, let's see what he has in store for them. And the defender finding a solution to the problem. Quick thinking to dispossess his opponent. Giving the ball to the opposition that time. Alex Hunter. Playing with purpose and control. Well, body in the way. And cleared away. And a substitution in the offing. Marco Asensio. And Lucas Vasquez, not far away at all with the volley.
Well, to catch it like that, you've got to have really good technique, and oh, so close.
Well, it's come down to the final 20 minutes here. Throw-ins given. This is Kroos. Tremendous vision. He's really sliced them open. He had just the goalkeeper to beat. He's got it completely wrongly.
Well, he won't be watching that when he gets home tonight on a replay.
Marco Asensio. Well, that's very smart defending, and now they have the ball again. This is Varane. The ball with Luka Modric. It's with Alex Hunter. And Hunter, what's he going to do? Not a strong glove on the ball from the keeper. Clattered away. They've decided that now is the time to go to the bench. The ball with Luka Modric. Simple for the keeper dealing with that long-range effort. Diaby. Here's Ramos. An inability to keep hold of the ball there. Modric. It's with Alex Hunter. And the referee is going to add on 3 minutes. Battaglia. A highly purposeful attack, this. The emphasis on getting the ball forward. And there the story ends tonight. 3 points for Real Madrid.
Well, when you're assessing the game afterwards, there's little boxes to be ticked, and they tick nearly all of them tonight. The defence, the goalkeeper, the midfield, the forwards look sharp. Really, really easy victory for them tonight. Clinical in front of goal. The manager, the coaches, the players and the fans are all happy tonight.
Chemistry, give me what's on your mind. Telling me everything, but it ain't happening. Wish I could read your vibe. Making moves. I don't think you're looking for. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ready, been waiting here. Can we get out of here? Wanna get you.
Controlling tight space leads to chances in the box. Keep your touches tight and quick. Shield the ball.
Boys, on again.
Good session, lads.
All I'm saying, Lily, is you keep putting the crosses in and I will keep heading them in, you know?
Good to finally see you using your head for something useful.
You know, I try. I really do.
And what would you say has earned you your transfer to French giants PSG?
Well, strikers all over Europe are scared of me. Because I don't give them room to breathe, do you know what I mean? It's all about winning your one-on-ones. And, making sure the man you're up against remembers who you're beating.
And how are you feeling about going up against your brother, Danny Williams, in the group stages? Must be a big thing for you.
Well, it might be for him. I can't say I care, really. Once you win one of these, nothing really phases you.
Interesting point. Although, if memory serves, you didn't actually play in the final, did you?
Well, it was the first season in Italy. I was getting bedded in. But I played a part in getting us there. Don't you worry about that. It's a squad game, mate. Do you understand? Anyway, I don't sweat my brother. How is he going to get the better of me? And if you're watching, Danny, I love you, mate.
Williams?
Boss, I was wondering if I could put some extra practice in, you know, work on what the gaffer wanted.
Oh, good on you. Well, the pitch is always available.
I'm not asking about the pitch. I'm wondering if you'd help train me.
What was that, Williams? Didn't quite hear you.
I was wondering if you would help train me.
Just say when, son.
Cool. Nice one. I'll text you the directions.
Directions?
Ooh, that was close. Just missed. Oh, you see that? That was close, wasn't it?
Flying in a runway, little Bobby never second guess that he gon' make it one day. One way or another, my brother.
A warm welcome to our live coverage. I'm Derek Ray with Lee Dixon alongside me in the commentary box, and we're back under the floodlights tonight for keenly awaited Champions League action as the group stage business begins for these two teams. Always an exciting prospect, Lee.
Yeah, massive expectations on Manchester United. Always a club of this size and stature, the money they've got to spend. They've been in the doldrums, you have to say, for a few years now, but obviously now, with the introduction of Danny Williams making his Champions League debut, can he push them the next step? I'm pretty sure he'll be nervous, but if you conquer those nerves, we're expecting big things from him.
It's the opening match day, Champions League group stage, match day one, underway. And here's the lineup for Manchester United. An element of caution about this selection.
Yeah, 4-5-1, Derek. The five players behind the lone striker will need to support him. Lots of very strong midfield offensively and also defensively. The back four will be protected throughout the game.
The opposition starting 11. Pretty well balanced, this formation, Lee.
Yeah, it can be a 4-2-3-1 in the offensive mode, but it can also go back to a 4-5-1 when you're defending. The lone striker will be supported by the three just behind him, especially the number 10, who will be given a free roll.
Juan Mata. Williams. Possession ceded by United. Manchester United, of course, the first English team to win the old European Cup in 1968, but not, Lee, the first British side, because a certain club by the name of Celtic beat them to it in 67.
Well, I knew it was only a matter of time before you got that fact in. You'd wedge that into any show we do, wouldn't you? But yeah, quite rightly so. But what a powerhouse of European football Manchester United are. Probably the biggest club in the world for me.
Dentinho. He's not really the man you want to be opposing in midfield. Paul Pogba, the Frenchman. Lee Dixon, what sort of performance do you think we'll see from Pogba?
Well, a hot one. Sometimes he blows hot and cold. I've seen him play for France and be so, so good. And then other times, very quiet.
Beautifully timed. On the ball, Taras Stepanenko. Tyson. Given away. Matic on the ball. And Mata. And Pogba. And now Danny Williams. Corner awarded to Manchester United. Corner kick played in. Thunder's clear. And the ball with Williams. The keeper was never likely to be in trouble then. Well, he's given us away. On the ball. Mata given away by Manchester United. Smalling. Nemanja Matic has it. Danny Williams. Pogba. Ander Herrera. Mata. And no-nonsense defensive clearance. Young. Pogba. Nemanja Matic has it. Now, let's see. Herrera. Now, Paul Pogba. Space and time for the cross. Well, the clearance half-hearted. It did look as though it was rather a fruitful avenue, but nothing doing. Pogba. Mata. Not too fussy in clearing his lines. Good call. We've had the official word. There will be a minimum of 2 added minutes. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? Excellent challenge. Well, can he make this move count? Will there be a tangible end product? And putting his body on the line. And that will do it for the first half here at the Theatre of Dreams. Paul Pogba, normally such a smooth operator, but might he be a bit cross with himself?
Well, it's not.
Underway then in the second half. And the two teams matching each other just about stride for stride. Stepanenko. It's all about translating threats into goals. Let's see what they can do here. Throw-ins given. Shaw. Now it's Alexis Sanchez. And the ball with Williams. It is a fruitful forward run. Williams! And it is the opening goal of the contest.
Well, it was always going to be a tight game, but now all of a sudden, one team ahead, things have got to change on both sides. Well, the keeper will be frustrated. He thought he'd saved it. He's so unlucky there. It's a good angle from him as well, but it's in the back of the net.
A bit more analysis as regards the goal. So, back underway in this game. Manchester United with the advantage. Stepanenko. Carrying a genuine threat here. Let's see what he has in store for them. Should he really have taken on the shot from that acute angle, Lee?
You're judged by your play on the pitch, and some of that play is decision-making, and he made a poor decision there.
Here's a change for Manchester United. And the ball with Williams. Potentially freedom for United on the flank. Williams! And a powerful effort, but just lacking accuracy.
Yeah, narrowly wide, Derek. Decent effort. He smashed it.
And we're inside the final 30 minutes. He's just a thorough reader of the game. And there we saw it. Marlos. Low driven ball. And the danger clear. Matyshev. Tyson. Well, that's very smart defending. And now they have the ball again. And plenty running towards goal. One man to beat. Big chance it is. Well, he saw the whites of the keeper's eyes and the whites of his outstretched gloves. Great goalkeeping.
Well, he's denied a certain goal there. Great reflexes from the keeper.
Well, both teams have had substitutes warming up and now both will rely on their respective benches. Played into the centre of the box. Given away. Martial distributing shrewdly. And offside it is. So 20 minutes to go. Stepanenko. textbook closing down, and now they're on the attack. Oh, he's through here, only the keeper to beat. Will it come back to haunt them? A golden opportunity, squandered lead.
What a chance. That was the game right there.
Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change. Ander Herrera. Anthony Martial. And the defender takes care of business. Shaw. The Red Devils have lost the ball. Stepanenko. With their noses in front in the second half. What will be the thinking in the camp, Lee Dixon?
Well, all the United players will be looking up at the clock. Time is ebbing away. They have such a delicate lead. Will they rue those missed chances? They could be costly.
Danny Williams. And it might be a favourable situation, this, for Manchester United. Teamwork might be the key.
Trafford, give a round of applause for today's man of the match.
Down by a goal, this could be the final opportunity to snatch something. We've been waiting to find out, now we know, a minimum of 3 added minutes here. And United will switch things around personnel-wise.
Substitution for Manchester United coming off the pitch. To be replaced by
crossing possibilities and dispossessed as it's on the ball. Stepanenko, full time, and Manchester United claim all 3 points in their opening fixture in the Champions League.
Yeah, really, really strong start. That's what you need. But with 5 games to go, very important you stay in the now. One game at a time, Derek. Bit of a cliche.
First Champions League game for you, Danny. Enjoy the experience.
Well, I mean, it was such an honour when the boss picked me for this game. I mean, as you know, Champions League is everything to this club. So the fact that he put some faith in me and you know, put me in the side, that's that means a lot. It means a lot.
Big responsibility.
Yeah, I know, it's massive, but... You know, I just try and put the graft in and the hard work and take each match as it comes.
Don't forget to enjoy it too.
Oh, yeah, I'll try.